Why is it bouncing?
Well, the up and down bouncing is because it keeps sticking down a bit. The slight wiggling is because it isn't tuned properly. I like to tune within any ground effects itself. So that when you're looking at the landing, it's all stable. And then it seems like the rest of it takes care of itself. See, I go up past the propeller's ground effect and it stops the up and down bouncing. So keep it down ground effect, tell me what kind of needs to be fixed at this point. Now it's a very calm day today, it's probably what, 3 mile an hour wind. There's natural wind, and if there was, we're covered by so many trees.
There's a big bit of rock behind those trees.
Trees, hill. So, when you're here at the table, in the golden ring, if I fly down there, then I'll probably see the effects of the wind there, but I haven't got my glasses on, so I'm not going to fly around there.
I thought you could need your glasses. Well, you could see fine.
I can see great. Got perfect 20/20 vision. Perfect. I can see that there's a multi-rotor up in the air.
Yeah, but you got to tell how many props it's got other than knowing it.
Well, it's got four of them in it. I haven't built this to be a fast fly, I've built this to be a long fly. I've never been a racer. And I might finish the day. When I go up in there, I just want to relax. Maybe have a little look around. Because I'm having a little spot of difficulty with the throttle routine. So it feels like it's got way too much tech. With a 450mm factory, I don't even think it comes to 200 grand yet. I think it was, put 2 600s side by side on the scales with it, and it came to 220. As it stands right now, it was 150 grams, but I made some alterations and changed the camera, so it's now 160 grams without the battery. The canopy is from an RC Explorer RCI Extreme. It was what people had back then, I suppose, and there were people who had difficulties with it, and people who loved it, and people who probably still have it to this day. couple of years ago I saw an online shop selling the kind of things off. And I thought, oh, I'll get a few of them. And I got to it. We make the money to sell it up in the air for a flip. I'd say this was built to fly, not to withstand the punishment. Okay, because it's just not very substantial. Only a little bit of training and going to check it needs. It's not like... and a 450 mAh lipo, but that's a bit long. I think I'll have to set the standard alarm beep at 3.4 and then set the low alarm beep at 3.2. I don't like the way the screen is doing that, but what I do like is that it's my Bodge FPV screen. Banggood was selling these cheapish. They was 30 something quid. Oh, I didn't scroll that antenna properly. Hang on a minute. Oh, the lines are still there. So they were selling their FPV screen cheapish. I thought, yeah, I'll get one of them. Bought a DVR for my transmitter. Then I can sit here like this, see, all nice. Any table, that's a good angle. If it's not, change it a little bit. This is up and down, left, right. Any angle you want, really, just set it there. I can more or less see everything perfectly from here.